Subscribe to our channel and click on the bell button to receive important financial updates faster than anybody else.
Friends, welcome to another video on your channel, Profit in Equities. Now, if you like our content, please don't forget to hit the like button. Also, subscribe to our channel and click on the bell button to receive important financial updates at the earliest. Now, HDFC Securities is a premier brokerage firm in India. Here, we present 5 stocks which they believe will boost your portfolio returns significantly. Also, if you feel that this content is beneficial, don't forget to share this video because a lot of other people could also get benefited by watching this video. Also, friends, once you see this video, please use this list as a watch list and then perform your own analysis to suit your desired portfolio returns. Please watch this video to know more. Now, the first stock on the list is Greaves Cotton Limited, which is available at 141.50, and the target price here has been set at 208. The price when this stock was initially recommended was 136.60. Now, if you were to look at this company, the code for it is GREAVESCOT. Now, Greaves Cotton Limited is a holding company which is engaged in manufacturing of engines and engine applications, manufacturing and trading of agro products, trading of spares related to engines and construction equipment. The company's segments include engines, infrastructure equipment and others. Now, if you were to look at the 1-year chart for this company, you would see that the company was on a consistent downtrend for the major part of the year. But of late, there has been a huge spurt in the prices of this company. The market cap is 3455.53 crores, which means that the company is a mid-cap one. The EPS is 7.42, which translates into a price to earnings ratio of 19.07, which is much below the industry PE of 32.39. The book value is 37.71, which translates into a price to book ratio of 3.75. Now, the dividend yield for this company is a very strong factor at 3.89, whereas the promoter holding here is average at 51.00. The 52-week high for the company stands at 178.55, whereas the 52-week low for the stock stands at 112.35. Now, Greaves Cotton is one of the leading players in the engines and farm equipment space. Also, robust balance sheet, strong cash flows, consistent dividend payout makes the company attractive according to HDFC Securities. And these are the basic reasons why HDFC Securities thinks that this company could go ahead and create a lot of wealth for the portfolios where this is included. Now, the second company on the list is Salasar Techno Engineering Limited, which is available at 310.20, and the target price here has been set at 401. The price when this stock was initially recommended was 306.35. The code for the company is SALASAR. Now, Salasar Techno Engineering Limited is a provider of steel solutions in India. The company is a provider of customized steel fabrication and infrastructure solutions for telecommunication towers, transmission towers and substation structures, and also solar module mounting structures. Now, if you were to look at the 1-year chart for the stock, you would see that essentially it's not done much and has largely been range bound. The market cap of the stock is 412.11 crores, which means that the company is still a small cap one. The EPS is 14.81. which means that the company is available at a price to earnings ratio of 20.95, which is much cheaper compared to the industry PE of 35.78. The book value is 71.01, which translates into a price to book ratio of 4.37. The debt to equity is 0.5492, whereas the return on equity is 0.1917. Now, the company does not currently pay out any dividends, and if you were to look at the promoter holding, this is a very strong number here at 74.94. The 52-week high for the company stands at 344.70, whereas the 52-week low is 198. Now, the main reasons why HDFC Securities thinks that this could be an outperformer going forward are: this company has a diversified product portfolio across segments, bringing more opportunity to boost revenues. Also, with established relationships with clients could help generate more revenue going forward. It also has a robust order book and excellent pre-qualification credentials. Also, this is expected to receive more orders, leading to rising capex in energy, infra and railway projects going forward. Now, the third company on the list is Hikal Limited, which is available at 227.20, and this stock was initially recommended at 227.60. The target price here has been set at 290. Now, the code for the company is HIKAL, and Hikal Limited is engaged in the manufacturing of various chemical intermediates, specialty chemicals, active pharmaceutical ingredients, APIs, and contract research activities. The company offers pharmaceuticals and agrochemicals. Its segments include crop protection and pharmaceuticals. Now, if you were to look at the one-year chart, you would see that the company is almost at the same level at which it began the year at. The market cap of the company is 1867.60 crores, which means that the company is still a small cap one. The EPS is 8.43, which translates into a price to earnings ratio of 26.95, which is a bit cheaper compared to the industry price to earnings ratio of 31.55. The book value is 65.31, which translates into a price to book ratio of 3.48. The dividend yield here is 0.53, which is average, and the promoter holding here is decent at 68.77. The 52-week high for the stock stands at 264, whereas the 52-week low is 191.30. Now, HDFC Securities thinks that it being into the crop protection and pharmaceutical API segment, this company would have a plethora of opportunities to increase their revenues and to tap into new growth areas. Also, they expect 12% revenue and 38% PAT CAGR over FY17 to 19E. Now, these are primarily the reasons why they think that this company should do well going forward. Now, the fourth company on the list is Manappuram Finance Limited, which is available at 118.55. The price when this stock was recommended was 115.60. The target here has been set at 158. Now, the code for the company is MANAPPURAM. Now, Manappuram Finance Limited is a non-banking financial company, also called an NBFC. The company is engaged in offering gold loans, microfinance, housing loans, and commercial vehicle loans. The company operates in the financing segment, and its geographical segment includes the domestic part of India. Its activities includes gold loan, money transfer, domestic money transfer, foreign exchange, SME and loan against property, depository services, and commercial vehicle loans. Now, if you were to look at the one-year chart, you would see that this company has created some money for their shareholders. The market cap of the company is 9981.47 crores, which means that the company is a mid-cap one. The EPS is 8.97, whereas this company has a book value of 39.32. Now, the price to earnings ratio is 13.22, which is much below the industry PE of 46.62. The price to book ratio here is 3.02, which again is decent. The debt to equity is a bit on the higher side, but which is understandable considering that it's a non-banking financial company, and this figure stands at 2.5615. The return on equity is 0.2166. The dividend yield is okay at 1.69, whereas the promoter holding here is a bit low at 34.66. The 52-week high for the stock stands at 126.40, whereas the 52-week low is 78.35. Now, if you were to look at the main reasons, this company has been increasing its share of non-gold loan businesses, which is a positive. Also, gold loans market is expected to regain ground, and asset quality deterioration peaked out and is set to improve going forward. Also, this company is expected to better its storing mechanisms, which would basically reduce its operating expenses. Also, it trades at close to 2 cross FY20E adjusted book value, which means that the company is a buy on the stock with a target price of 158. Now, the final company on the list is HT Media Limited, which is available at 105.20, and the target price here has been set at 119. The price when this stock was recommended was 106.65. The code for the company is HTMEDIA. Now, HT Media Limited is a media company and is engaged in printing and publishing of newspapers. The company's segments include printing and publishing, radio, broadcast and entertainment, and also digital. Now, if you were to look at the one-year chart for the company, you would see that this stock has been on a consistent uptrend and a lot of wealth has been created here. The market cap of the company is 2466.78 crores, which means that the company is a mid-cap one. The EPS is 7.27, which translates into a price-to-earnings ratio of 14.47, which is below the industry PE of 18.13. The book value is 72.46, which again means that the company is available at a very decent price-to-book ratio of 1.45. The dividend yield is 0.38, whereas the promoter holding here is also good at 69.51. The 52-week high is 118.40, whereas the 52-week low is 79.15. Now, HDFC Securities thinks that with a strong ad spend on the back of coming elections and robust growth in radio and digital segments, this company's growth momentum would continue and the company would be expected to go ahead and do very well going forward. Now, friends, having seen this list, please don't consider any of these to be stock recommendations. Please go ahead and do your own research and please treat this list as just some sort of a laundry list from which you can go ahead and use your own research to individually pick stocks. Thanks for watching and you have a good day.